Well, Thom Bierdz is a much-loved and legendary American actor who turned heads as the ultra-hunky and handsome Phillip Chancellor III. This on the mega-hit daytime drama The Young and the Restless. He was a pin-up boy for many, but for Thom Bierdz, life wasn't always so rosy. I had the great pleasure of catching up with Thom, and he candidly revealed all about the highs and lows of his extraordinary life and incredible career. Take a look. He's the super hunky former daytime soap opera stud who turned heads and soared to fame in the 80s as bad boy Phillip Chancellor III on The Young and the Restless. But then in true daytime drama fashion, and after a shocking demise, Thom's character sensationally rose from the dead in what was a major jaw-dropping plot twist.
Philip died. It's you, isn't it?
It's me.
The talented star with the dark and smouldering good looks once graced the covers of countless TV magazines all over the world. But these days, and by his own choice, you won't find him anywhere near Tinseltown. When was it, Thom, that you escaped the craziness of Hollywood, as they say, for the serenity and, I guess, the peace of where you are now in Lake Arrowhead, which is the mountains just behind Los Angeles, for those who don't know?
Well, it was my midlife crisis about 10 years ago exactly that I decided I didn't want to be in Los Angeles anymore. The stimulus was too much for me. I'm a real sensitive guy. That's why you see I do what I do. I'm a painter and stuff like that. And I couldn't deal with the crowd.
Sounds like one of your father's speeches.
So what if it is? I thought your father was at Auschwitz. He was.
Like I said, I'm going to that rally.
Do you remember your first TV role?
Highway to Heaven with Michael Landon. And what was funny about it is I didn't realize that they can change the script after you get hired. So all of a sudden there were blue pages and I just ignored them because I had my white pages. And then Michael Landon said, okay, let's go to the next scene. Like, what scene? This scene right here? You've got 5 minutes to learn it. I learned it in 5 minutes.
In his early Hollywood days, and fresh out of Wisconsin with just $5,000 in his pocket, an excited Thom landed a role in St. Elmo's Fire with Demi Moore, Rob Lowe and Emilio Estevez. But his part got cut. And he almost had a speaking role in Back to the Future.
Yeah, I just had one line. They decided to replace me with a clock.
So you very quickly learnt there is a savage side to Hollywood and it's called a cutting room floor.
Oh, I didn't know what to expect. It really didn't matter because I really had this drive inside of me and I knew I was going to succeed no matter what.
That's right.
About what?
You all believed a miracle had happened.
And succeed you did, because 1986, along comes, I guess you could say, the role of a lifetime in Phillip Chancellor III in the hottest, top-rating daytime TV drama series in the world, The Young and the Restless.
Yeah, it was great. And I would be paid thousands of dollars to be flown to a city. I'd sign autographs. You know, so it was a great ego trip. But as much as I knew, hey, I'm doing what I know I can do, I wasn't who I really was. I was gay closeted, and I was wrestling with that.
Thom, back then, as I understand it, they had things called morality clauses, so you really couldn't be yourself, could you?
They probably still have those, but they're a little different what morality is these days. But yeah, nobody was coming out at that point.
I mean, gosh, this is only the 80s, but I mean, when you think about it, the 80s seems so far back. Was it a genuine risk that if you did reveal your true self, if you did have that kind of integrity and honesty to be real, that you could lose your career? Was that a genuine threat?
Very genuine. I wanted to be Tom Cruise, and Tom Cruise couldn't be Tom Cruise if he said he was gay. Not that he is, but if you imagine that he said that, that would have certainly hurt his career. That's what I wanted to be, yeah.
After three high-octane years on The Young and the Restless, Thom's manager advised him to leave the show to focus on movie roles in the big screen. And with word out, the offers started rolling in. But just as Thom was getting set for the next exciting chapter of his showbiz life, unspeakable, unfathomable tragedy struck. So 1989, you get a shocking phone call from your sister in Wisconsin. Your mother had been murdered by your brother, Troy.
Yeah, at the time that I decided to leave Young and the Restless in 1989, a few months later, my paranoid schizophrenic brother murdered our mother in the kitchen. It was such an unbelievable turn of events, roller coaster, that I wrote a book about it, Forgiving Troy. And this is something I had to write because it was just unbelievable. And it's like I couldn't tell you in 3 minutes what happened. You have to see to believe it, to believe how gone he was, how schizophrenic, how he rotted researching his history and getting 400 pages of court records of his satanic poems and troubles. Then thinking, my poor mom, how she put up with that for years and years and didn't tell me. She didn't want to worry me. I mean, what a horrible fate.
Thom's brother was sentenced to life in jail, and through penning his soul-bearing and mesmerizing memoir, Thom has learned to forgive Troy. Following that horrific chain of events, which included the suicide death of his other brother, Greg, Thom was invited back onto The Young and the Restless, and his character was finally given the opportunity to come out.
And this is about me. It's about the truth that I've been hiding all this time.
What truth?
I'm gay.
But, as it turns out, a life away from the bright lights of Hollywood, but with a paintbrush in hand, well, that's been Thom's mental saviour. Do you think, Thom, that painting has, in many ways, been a saviour for you?
Yeah, let me answer that with pictures, with just a couple pictures here. Because my best stuff is the emotional stuff that I have used as like therapy over the years. I enjoy painting. It's a good job.
I gotta go back to Australia.
For how long?
Indefinitely.
Your character, Phillip from The Young and the Restless, oddly enough, is here in Australia now. Is that right?
That's right.
Have you any idea what he might be doing here in Australia? Should we send a search party for him?
He opened a bar. That's where they found me 10 years ago. So check out all the bars. Now you have a reason.